today at Agecroft Cemetery looking at the gravestone of Ken Reed. Now, Ken Reed, a lot of people may not have heard of this chap. He lived in Salford most of his life. He was an illustrator for the Manchester Evening News cartoonist. He's never had the recognition he fully deserves. That's my personal opinion, and hopefully today we'll be able to rectify that. He, mostly in my opinion, famous for the Fudge and Speck series in the Manchester Evening News that ran in the 30s, 40s, 50s. He also wrote for the Dandy and Beano. He did create such characters as Roger the Dodger, Jonah, the Unlucky Sailor, Face Eight, Frankenstein. Now, he died aged 67. For me, this is a nice piece on his grave. A lot of the graves here have the actual person. I think it's a great tribute what Ken Reed has done, or his family. We'll tell you more about Ken Reed later on, because I'm going to meet his son, Anthony. He's going to explain more about his father, his life, his times at the Manchester Evening News, growing up in Salford, and more about the man.
Strange question. Did you realise your father was famous?
Not when I was young, no, because my two uncles, Bill Allride and Albert Allride, they were both cartoonists for the DC Thompsons, again, Dandy and Beano and others. So if I went on holiday visiting them, they both lived up Scotland, they'd be doing cartoons as well. So I suppose when I was little, I imagined that everyone was doing cartoons. It was only when I got older and my dad got an award, he got Cartoonist of the Year award in 1976, I think it was. We went to London and he was presented it by Bob Monkhouse. So when Bob Monkhouse presented him with an award, I realised that he must be famous in some way. The main ones I remember are Fudge the Elf, of course, because I used to read through the stories when I was a kid at night, my favourite ones, and because he had the whole story, I could actually flick through it to the best parts, missing some out, whereas the people in the paper had to wait every night for the next one to come through.
His artwork, it reminds me almost like fantasy art, not something like Alice in Wonderland, Lewis Carroll or Tolkien in us. Do you get that impression with the Fudge and Speck?
Well, with Fudge and Speck especially, it starts off, he's got elements of everything you've said, but there's a lot of sci-fi stuff in it. Fudge's trip to the moon, the Micromen, which was an old civilization living in a small ball. Fudge was shrunk many, many times. He went down the old well, was swimming around with microbes. That's because of my father's interest in pond life and him buying a microscope. So it was a mixture of fairy tale and sci-fi.
I think it's time that there should be a Ken Reed revival. You know, his artwork deserves a fuller, wider audience. Do you think there's a chance of this happening?
Well, I think he is famous now. As you know, you can just do a Google search for him and you'll find Ken Reed. You can buy Ken Reed stuff. But I don't think he's been acclaimed in the area, the Salford area where he was born and lived all his life. This seems to be a bit lacking, really.
Well, I saw a great tribute about your father by a chap of mine of my age. He was telling me about Fudge and Speck. He said that's how he learned to read and write, with his father in the Evening News. He used to sit him down and point the story out to him and read. I think that's a lovely tribute to your father and his artwork. And all I can say is I am a great fan of your father's work, and thanks ever so much for speaking to me today about your dad.
Oh, it's all right. Thanks, Tony.